Hey, good morning, class. So our topic for today, which is our second topic for midterm, is about accounting concepts and principles. So we're done with types of businesses according to activities. So now let's start our second topic. So first, let's review first our previous topic. So we have here a presentation, no? We have your accounting and we have accounting for businesses. So we have a types of businesses according to organization, in which there are three types of businesses according to organization. So we have sole proprietorship, partnership, and corporation. So we have already differentiated this three types of businesses according to organization. So our previous topic is the three types of businesses according to operations. According to operations or according to activities, we have service business, merchandising business, and manufacturing businesses. So let's start now with the accounting principles. So first is the business entity principle. So a business enterprise is separate and distinct from its owner or investor. So when you put up a business, whether it's a sole proprietorship, whether it's a partnership, corporation, or you are specialized in a service activity, merchandising activity, or manufacturing activity, or even hybrid, always remember that the business is separate from its owner or investor. So meaning, ang operations ni business is separate sa operations ng personal, no, personal transactions ni owner. So we have here an example. So if the owner has a barber shop, the cash of the barber shop should be reported separately from personal cash. Of course, the barber shop is a separate entity from its owner. So si barber shop maka-income, that income will be reported for the barber shop only, kasi business entity is daw tao man na siya class, pero wala na siya yasang form, no? Or a definite structure, no? It's somewhat like an imaginary person, bala class, no? And it has a distinct personality, a separate and distinct personality from its owner or investor. So, muna siya nga, dapat si business is separate from its owner. Kay, no? Example, ang income ni barbershop, butang mo diretso sa bulsa ni owner. So, paano muna karon ma-monitor ng imong business is earning or not? Kiti ang cash mo is ginsamo muna sa cash sang tag-iya. So what if this si tag-iya damo na daan kwarta, no? So wala ka kabalo nga your business is losing kay you thought that damo kwarta ang business kay ang income to sang business mo is ginsamo mo sa imo personal cash in which damo ka na sinaya nga daan, no? So for better monitoring man na ma-monitor mo nga your business is growing or not, so you should follow the business entity principle in which the business is separate from its owner. So hindi mo pagsamuan ang transactions ni owner sa transactions ni business. So you have here a second example na the owner had a business meeting with a prospective client. The expenses that come with that meeting should be part of the company's expenses. So if the owner paid for gas for her personal use, it should not be included as part of the company's expenses. So amo na siya ang problema for me sang naga sa mga accountants, sa mga bookkeepers, no, kay kumayo ka sa mga ano ni mga resibo kay owner, no, nagapabukip sa imo. Actually, na tag nila si mo bisan mga personal nga mga resibo, mga bayad sa gas, ba even bayad sa kuryente, no, balaan mo gid na ya klase nga ila gina personal kay nagagwa sa bila sang isang ila nga ngalan, no. Ay, hindi ngalan sang business. So, amo pag gid na siya class, ang paano mo mabalaan kay si business is gina-register mo na siya sa DTI. So, may ngalan, gina siya yung nga iya, no? Dugin, pabunyagan mo siya balaklas. Eh, na-register mo siya sa City Hall. Kuha ka business permit. Na-register mo pag gina siya sa BIR. Then, ma-issue, gina iya resibo. So, sa resibo, dra mo na makita ang ngalan sang imo negosyo. So, kung sole proprietorship, ngalan sang tag-iya. So, kung partnership, wala pa man ko kakita resibo sang partnership, pero usually makita mo na ya sa resibo ang halan sang business, no? So amo na sa class. So that's business entity principle. So we have the next principle is the going concern principle. So when we speak of going concern, the business is expected to continue indefinitely. So we always view a business that it will continue indefinitely, no, for a long period of time. So amo man na class nga nagpatukod ka man gani negosyo, no, at kung pwede lang mag stay na da siya forever. But no, nang di taman may imbitar, no, may losses, no, until you declare bankruptcy. But we always view a business entity in a going concern principle. So you have here, when preparing financial statements, you should assume that the entity will continue indefinitely. So mo man permi ang aton nga ginapangabay nga kabay pa nga maglawig ang aton nga business, no. So that's how we view the business entity, no, in a going concern principle. So, ginafollow taman na siya. So, wala taman ginapangabay nga ang business will end after 1 year, after 2 years, no? So, ang ato na iyalani nga ginapangayo is it will continue to operate in a indefinite period of time. So, that's the going concern principle. Next is the time period principle. So, financial statements are to be divided into specific time interval. So, time period principle sa accounting, wala tayo nagapagusto sa aton nga reporting, sa aton nga time period. So, we have sa accounting, we can report monthly, no? So, operations for the month, ang results nina is, we report is monthly, no, depende kung ano ang kinanglan sang tagiya. Monthly, we have quarterly, every 3 months, semi-annually, 6 months, 6 months, 6 months, no, so every 6 months you report, another 6 months you report, and usually, the reporting sa accounting is annually. So, ginakat na siya. So, operations, January to December, if calendar year ang ginagamit ni business. So, the operations, the results of it must be reflected in the report, no, from January to December. So, that's annually. So, we have your examples. Philippine companies are required to report financial statements annually. So, for the year. And the salary expenses from January to December 2015 should only be reported in 2015. No? Kay amuna sa mga expenses nga nag-refer only for the year 2015. So, hindi mo na siya pwede report sa 2016. Kay that expenses pertains only to year 2015. So, that time period principle. Wala tanaga pinagusto report lang sa accounting. Next is monetary unit principle. So amounts are stated into a single monetary unit. So we have your example. Jollibee should report financial statements in pesos even if they have a store in the United States. So we know that a Jollibee corporation or the Jollibee Food Corporation is a domestic corporation, a Filipino corporation. So kung Filipino, our currency here is in pesos. So since Jollibee has branches all over the world, itong ilan, itong report is ang report ni Jollibee USA kung dito sa ila is in dollars kung sila ito yung ma-prepare. Pero pag labot di, pag consolidate na bala, no, consolidation is ginatingob tanan na ang mga financial statements, ang mga operations, no, summary of operations sang company is it is converted into pesos, no, ka hindi ka man ka consolidate sang pesos kag dollars, no, i-add mo sila ti, di ba, 1 peso is subong is 48, $1 is 48 pesos, so 49. So kung i-combine mo na sila dollars and pesos, so misleading na ang imong amount. So you should convert dollars into pesos, then pwede mo na sila ma-consolidate. So another is IHOP should report financial statements in dollars even if they have a branch here in the Philippines. So si IHOP naman niya is a foreign corporation, so their financial statements, no, their results of operations are stated in dollars. But they have a branch here in the Philippines. So in the Philippines, we use pesos. So in time of consolidation, pesos are converted into dollars so that they can produce a report, a financial statement in dollars. So that's the monetary unit principle. Amounts are stated in a single monetary unit. So next is the objectivity principle. Objectivity principle, financial statements must be presented with supporting documents. So when we speak of objective, wala ta na iaklas ga pinagusto lang based ang aton mga haom, no? We report all our accounts, no? Our operations with supporting documents. No? Example here is when the customer paid Jollibee for their order, Jollibee should have a copy of the receipt to represent as evidence. No? Mahawid din na iya dapat ya si Jollibee sang resibo, no, ang resibo to nga gina-issue kay customer, dapat may copy man sila to support ang ilang sales, no, for that certain transaction. So, muna sa class, dapat may supporting evidence. Good. So, when a company incurred a transportation expense, a voucher should be prepared as evidence. So, that's the objectivity principle. So, those financial statements must be presented with supporting documents. Kay wala taya nagpinagusto man reporting, no? Drawing lang sang amount, butang sa financial statements mo, no, para mag-nami siya, no, kagwapas ang financial statements, taasin mo cash, taasin mo income, wala gali evidence. So, you are not following the objectivity principle sa accounting. Next is the cost principle. So, accounts should be recorded initially at cost. So, iya nga, presyo, sanggin, acquire mo siya. So, here we have an example. When Jollibee buys a cash register, it should record the cash register at its price when they bought it. No? Nagbakal sila bi sang January sang cash register worth 50,000. Dayon subong its price is 60,000. So pilay mo i-record. So you record your cash register for 50,000. Amo to siyang cost sang ginbakal mo sa. Next is a when a company purchases a laptop, it should be recorded at price it was purchased, no? Kung saan o siya ginacquire mo na siya, kung pila ginbayad mo, like, isang ginacquire mo siya, that should be recorded as its cost. Kamo na siyang i-report mo sa financial statements, imong accounting records. So that's the cost principle. Next is the accrual accounting principle. So when we speak of accrual accounting principle, we record revenue when it is earned and we record expenses when it was incurred. So revenue should be recognized when earned regardless of collection. No? You record revenue, no, when it is earned. Bisan wala ka pa may nabato ng cash. Accrual. You record expenses when it is incurred regardless of payment. So, you record expenses kung nagamit mo na siya even though wala mo pa siya nabayaran. So, that's the accrual accounting. So, wala tayo labot kung saan o nagagawa or nagusulod si cash. Now, for as long as our revenue is earned and our expenses are incurred, we already record sa accounting. That's accrual accounting principle. On the other hand, the cash basis principle in which revenue is recorded when collected and expenses should be recorded when paid. So, si cash basis naman niya, ngala niya pa lang, we record revenue under cash basis when we receive cash and we record expenses when we paid in cash. However, cash basis is not the generally accepted principle today nga. Ah. Expenses mo. Example, nagamit ka, nag-order ka mo office supplies December 2019. So if you use cash basis, nagamit mo na ang office supplies mo sa 2019, pero nagtapos ng 2019, nag-2020 na wala ka pa kabayad. So, kung i-record mo na kung saan mo ka makabayad, no, if you follow cash basis, nagamit mo na to expense, ang supplies expense mo sa 2019, pero 2020 ka na yan nagbayad, so gin-declare mo expenses mo sa 2020 in which wala siya yan nag-pertain or nag-connect sa 2019 mga operations. So, amo na nga, ang cash basis is not a generally accepted principle kay ma-debate na siya sa aton nga next nga principle, which is matching principle. So, dapat, kung saan o muna earn ang imo revenue, saan o muna ginobrahan, amo man na ang time nga mag-recognize ka sa imo nga income. So, as to expenses naman, kung saan o muna siya nagamit, saan o muna siya na-consume, amo man ang pag-record mo, no? Regardless kung saan o ka nagbayad. So, example here is, when a barber finishes performing his services, he should record it as revenue. So, when the barbershop receives an electricity bill, it should record it as an expense even if it is unpaid. So, I'm not class sample, no? You have January to December reporting. Calendar year mo ginasunod. Imo utilities ang December. Usually, di ba ang gamit mo na sa December, no? Electricity and water bill mo na. ang usage mo sa December, usually ang bill mo na is masunod. Ama is maabot January. No? So, as a November, gaabot ang bill mo for November in December. However, si December, very crucial ni siya. Year end na siya, di ba? December. So, bill mo sa December, January gaabot. So, since ara to sa accrual accounting, ang aton nga bill gaabot January, so we record sa December accrued expenses. Amo na siya ang gina-follow ya, the accrual accounting principle. Gina-accrue na sa December kay para maka-report tas ang insyakto sa aton expenses for that year. Example, for 2019. No, kay kung mahulat pa tas ang bill tas sa January, our expenses will be understated sa 2019 kay wala tatugin record ang expenses ni December nga nag-abot na sang January. So muna sa class ang example man ni accrual accounting principle nga gina-follow tana siya. So next is the matching principle. So cost should be matched with the revenue generated. Sa mga sambal ko kagina ang 2019 mga usage sa imo office supplies must be reported in 2019 kay gingamit mo ng office supplies for your operations in 2019 nga you operate to generate a revenue for that year. So since ang that office supplies daw mo to hamba ko nga kung magbalo ka cash basis sa accounting. So you record expenses na for the next year kay next year mo pa siya ginbayaran. So wala na ta naga-follow sa matching principle, duwa na ka principles ang nag-deviate kita. The accrual accounting principle and the matching principle wala na nag-match ang aton expenses sa aton nga revenue. So mo na siya class ang matching principle. So when you provide tutorial services to a customer and there is a transportation cost incurred related to the tutorial services, it should be recorded as an expense for that period. So dapat si revenue or si expenses must go hand in hand when it comes to reporting. Matching principle. Next is the disclosure principle. All relevant and material information should be reported. Wala tayang nagatago sa accounting since reporting niya ang aton ginaubra, no? The operations, we record operations, no? Agisa sa accounting, then eventually the preparation of financial statements. So in there, all relevant and material information should be reported, no? So we have an example. The company should report all relevant information about the business entity, about the operations of the business. So you have here conservatism principle, also known as prudence. So in case of doubt, assets and income should not be overstated while liabilities and expenses should not be understated. So when we speak of assets and income, it goes with benefits. Now, when we speak of liabilities and expenses, it goes with gasto. Sa gasto. So, sa conservatism principle, no, in case of doubt, if hindi ka sure, assets and income should be reported, should not be overstated. So, mas better nga magkulang ta sa reporting sa assets and income kung sa magsubra kita. That's conservatism. No? And in case of doubt, liabilities and expenses should not be understated. So, mas mayo nga magsubra kita sa liabilities and expenses. Excuse me. So, muna sa class ang conservatism principle. So, it's better nga mag-report kita, no, in case of doubt lang na niya class, no, if we have a, we don't have a definite ano pa ng evidence, no, as to when we report a particular account under assets and income, no, kung hindi pa ta sure bala sang iyang measurements kay hindi pa siya measurable, so much better if we report it understated ang aton reporting sa assets and income. Nubo aton reporting sa ilan. When we speak of liabilities naman yan, expenses, much better if we report them not to be understated. So, mas mayo nga taas aton reporting sa liabilities and expenses. We have here, in case of doubt, expenses should be recorded at a higher amount. Revenue should be recorded at a lower amount. So, muna siya class ang conservatism principle. The materiality principle, so in case of assets that are immaterial to make difference in the financial statements, the company should instead record it as an expense. Example, bakal ka, you are a corporation. So, usually, corporation, nag-gid man na siya. Nagbakal ka stapler. So, stapler is, lawig gid man gamit tayo mas ng stapler, tinuig man. So, since ang amount ni stapler is, example, 120 pesos, i-depreciate po pa na for 10 years mong gamit. So, since it is very immaterial, we report it na lang as expenses, no, under supplies expense. No, even though si supplies expense is very consumable, gina siya class, hindi na siya kalabot sa katuwag, ubos na na. No, so, muna, kay since si stapler, gunting, ano pa ginang lawig, mga gamit tayo, basta hindi lang madula, lahat na gina-depreciate, just like our machineries and equipment. So, lahat na siya gina-depreciate, kay since ang amount is very material na. No? So, we have here, example, a school purchase an eraser with an estimated useful life of 3 years. Yawan, kagid man naubos ang eraser, especially ang white ink. Pagid na, oh, ang correction ink, na dugay-dugay. Ang college ko, may correction ink ko sa first year. Sa nga nag-college ko, nakaubra ko, nagamit ko pa sa sulig-lawig ang gamit sa correction ink. So, since an eraser is immaterial relative to assets, it should be recorded as an expense. That's materiality principle. So, next is we have qualitative characteristics of financial statements. So, muna siya ang mga quality aspects ni financial statements. So, understandability. So, financial statements must be understandable. The information must be readily understandable to users of financial statements. Dapat, pagbasa mo sa financial statements, bisan ang as accountant, we produce financial statements nga even mga doctors, kamo mga IT experts, and other professions, magbasa sa sila sa financial statements is maintindihan nila. That's one of the qualitative characteristics of financial statements, understandability. This means that information must be clearly presented with additional information supplied in the supporting footnotes as needed to assist in clarification. So, paglantaw mo pa lang, paglantaw, busy doctor, sang financial statements, no? Ah, okay, sa common income, no? Kay tikitaon, tapos kadto siya sa notes, ang mga ara na daang breakdown man sa mga accounts. So, mansindihan mo lang siya. So, less ang mga jargons, no? Ang mga terms ba lang, para lang din sa accounting. So, muna siya. Understandability. Next is relevance. So, the information must be relevant to the needs of the users, which is the case when the information influences their economic decisions. This may involve reporting particularly relevant information or information whose omission or misstatement could influence, the economic decisions of users. So, relevance. Maglantaw sila sa financial statement, makuha nila kung ano ang ilang kinanglan. That's relevance. Makuha nila kung ano nilang kinanglan for their decision making. Amo na sa class. So, presina, inang si bangko, kung gusto mag-utang ni business sa bangko, lantawon na ni bangko imo financial statements. Lantawon niya na if you are capable of paying utang in case mag-grant sila utang sa imo. So, muna sa class, lantawon na nila. So, if makita nila that you are incapable of paying your liabilities, no, kaya ang imo liabilities, to be seen mo financial statement is very high in relation to your total assets. So, most probably, hindi kanila pag-grant sa ila utang. So, amo na ila nga decision. So, sa class, relevance. Next is reliability. The information must be free of material error and bias and not misleading. Thus, the information should faithfully represent the transactions and other events, reflect the underlying substance of events, and prudently represent estimates and uncertainties through proper disclosure. So when they speak of reliability, the information you get from the financial statements must be reliable, no? Free from bias, hindi siya misleading. So when they speak of reliable, masaligan mo ang information nga makuha mo da. Therefore, the information dira nga gin-present is insakto. Sama siyang reliable, no? It fully represent transactions and other events. Insakto iyang representation sa mga transactions, no? Reflect the underlying substance of events and prudently represent estimates and uncertainties through proper disclosure. That's reliability. Next is comparability. The information must be comparable to the financial information presented for other accounting periods so that users can identify trends in the performance and financial position of the reporting entity. Comparability, you compare your current year operations to your previous year's operations. Okay. Later on class, we will see kung anong itsura sa financial statements. But usually, ang financial statements, gina-prepare is in comparison. Current year compared to prior year. Hamo na isang reporting, no? For example, cash. Cash, then cash ni prior year, then cash ni current year. So, na-compare mo if nag-increase or decrease ang mga accounts mo sa balance sheet, sa income statement, and sa imo mga cash flows, hamo na siya class, ang one of the qualitative characteristics man sa financial statement. It should follow the comparability presentation, bala nga para makita mo ang trend whether nagnubo or nagtaas ang imo nga income, imo nga assets, imo liabilities, and sa notes naman is makita mo nga nag-increase or nag-decrease ina. So man sa class comparability. So to review, the qualitative characteristics of financial statements is understandability, relevance, reliability, comparability. And that's the end of our second topic. And thank you very much. Dali lang ko ma-end kay kinatawag na ko sa ako ni Nablik ng mamahaw. Thank you. Have a nice day ahead.